through the Father and the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today, actually, the fourth Sunday. Today, the fourth Sunday of the blessed month of Tuba. And the month of Tuba, actually, because we celebrate in the month of Tuba the baptism of our Lord God, Savior Jesus Christ. Therefore, the theme during the month of Tuba was all about baptism. Baptism. And the story today, actually, from John chapter 9, a beautiful story that all of us know very well, the healing of the man who was born blind. And also, the man born blind is a symbol of baptism, actually. In baptism, we receive enlightenment, spiritual enlightenment. For the man also was born blind, actually, the Lord granted him a new enlightenment. His life would change completely. When somebody blind, and suddenly his eyes is opened, his life will change, and when you look at everything is different. For therefore, the theme about spiritual enlightenment. For therefore, today, actually, the sinful man is a symbol of somebody far away from God, a symbol of reduced repentance. How through repentance we can receive this spiritual enlightenment, and God can open our eyes. So how beautiful, actually, the gospel start with the first verse. It said, now as Jesus passed by, he saw a man who was blind from birth. It's amazing, this story, actually, Jesus approached the man. Always our Lord God, Savior Jesus Christ, seeking each one of us. As he said in the book of Revelation, chapter 2, verse 20, he said, I'm standing knocking on your door. If you open to me, I will come in, I will enter, and I will have a fellowship with you. Always our Lord seeking each us. I'm sure you and I, we hear God's message every day in our life. We always hear every day God's message about repentance. Come back to me. For therefore, the Lord actually went to the blind man to seek him. Number two, actually, we see here in the story, the question of the disciple. The disciple, as soon as they saw this man was born blind, they asked Jesus, if this man really sinned or his parents? But actually, today, Jesus, actually, our Lord God, Savior Jesus Christ, changed how we look at hardship. He said, neither this man nor his parents, but actually for the glory of God. And that's actually right in our beautiful attitude toward hardship. When God allows any certain hardship in our life, it doesn't matter what kind of hardship, we always take it for one reason only. We say, this is only for the glory of God. Following that, actually, our Lord God, Savior Jesus Christ, he made a clay, and he anointed his eyes of the blind man with the clay, and he told him, go and wash. You know, something very strange, actually, you know. The man is blind. When you make a clay and you put it in somebody's eyes, which are normal eyes, he will actually become blind. But the Lord actually take the clay and put it in the eyes and told him, go and wash. One thing about this glad man here, he did not argue with the Lord God. He did not say, well, what are you doing here? Does not make sense. How can you put the clay in my eyes and told me, go and wash? And how I'm going to go and wash? I do not even know where the place is. You are the Lord. You can tell me, just put your hand on my eyes and tell me you're healed. I'm going to be healed. Yeah, I've done this many times. But it seemed like this man was desperate for our Lord God, Savior Jesus Christ. And that's how repentance starts, actually, in the heart. Repentance starts in our heart when you and I feel I'm desperate for the Lord. I need the Lord. I need to repent. I need to come back to him. For this man actually was very desperate for the Lord. And he went and he washed. And the Bible said he went means he took an action. Repentance, how are you and I can take an action? Number two, washed, cleansed himself. Number three, actually start seeing. He starts seeing. His life completely changed. The way he walk, the way he talk, the way he eats right now. He can distinguish which food I'm going to eat right now. But his life completely changed. But the point I want to mention here that repentance starts with the heart that someone who is desperate for God. When you feel you are in need of God, you want God in your life, for therefore you will right away repent and run to your Father of confession. That's why today I want to focus with you on four important points about the characteristic of a good repentance or an orthodox repentance. Number one has to be firm determination. Very important. If you want to repent, number one, you have to sit with yourself and you have to be firm with yourself. Firm with yourself. There's a beautiful verse, actually, St. John said in 2 Corinthians 6:2, he said, behold, now is the acceptable time. Now is the acceptable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. The word now repeated twice to emphasize now at the moment. When you hear his voice, as the Bible mentioned, do not harden your heart. For therefore, repentance needs a firm determination. Somebody decided, you know what? I will go see my father. All of us, we love the story of the prodigal son. The only reason, one thing only, because he was so firm when he decided, when he realized that his life is really far away from his parents, and he want to come back, he decided, I will go around. I will go to my father and tell him, Father, I have sinned against heaven before you. Number one has to be firm by you, firm determination. Number two has to be complete. The most important characteristic of repentance or a true repentance has to be complete. Means basically repentance of the mind, repentance of the feeling, repentance of the heart, repentance of the will, repentance of the action. But it has to be a complete repentance. When I go, I see, sometimes I'm afraid to tell Abuna something, or even when I talk to God, I know, as we always say during the liturgy, if one plant he have forbidden me to eat from it. You know, one thing is I'm struggling with it. If I can be able to overcome it, I will be able to eat to come back to God. For number one has to be firm. Number two has to be complete. Number three has to be continuing. Our understanding of a true repentance, we don't believe in repentance, it's just a moment and that's it. But repentance actually is a life that you live every day. Daily repentance. You wake up in the morning, you say to God, you know, it's a beautiful new day. Grant me, enlighten my heart, enlighten my mind, enlighten my soul. At night you sleep, before you sleep, you tell God, all the sin that I commit today. So you're really experiencing repentance on a daily basis. But even every hour in your life you repent. You fall into sin, you stand up. That's why we give, during Lent, we always tell the youth, make sure to do Matanya. Because the Matanya is a symbol of repentance. Matanya means a change. Change of mind, change of thought. And the Matanya is a symbol of repentance because every time you fall down, you stand up. And that's what repentance is really, it's a struggle. But it has to be something continuing every day. And the most beautiful expression, by the way, David the prophet and the king used, when after he committed the sin, he said, wash me from my sin. Wash me, how many times you ask yourself, you wash your hand every day? Many times, every time, you can countless. How many times you wash yourself every day? Every time you feel like you wake up, you want to wash yourself. That's repentance. The beautiful expression to explain to us repentance is something continuing. Life I have to live, it's the beautiful expression when David the prophet and the king after his sin, he said, wash me from my sin. For you and I, we need to be washing every day in our sin. Daily washing. Daily, hourly washing. We have to repent every day. And one time, actually, our Lord God said, Christ, this is, you will find it in Exodus chapter 19. He used the word wash. He went to Moses and told Moses, the people actually complained to Moses and said, you know what, how God always come to you and he does, well, was, you tell, you talk to God and you come tell us about what God told you. We want to see God. So Moses went to God and told him, look, you know what, he went to the mountain of Sinai. He said, the people of Israel actually wanted to see you. So he said, fine, you know what, they want to see me? I will appear to them. For the Lord actually came to Moses and said, look, this is in Exodus 19:10. He said, go to the people and consecrate them today and tomorrow and let them wash their clothes. Let them wash their clothes. And let them actually go to the mountain because on the third day I will appear to them. For I love the Lord to tell him, look, you know what, in order for us to see the Lord, we have to be repentant. We have to repent. And repentance is basically wash your clothes. When you and I have a beautiful shirt, you always like to wash it. As long as it gets dirty, right away you run to wash it. For the beautiful thing about repentance is something continuing, something you have to wash. For every time you wash your hand, tell God, I wanted to wash my heart. I wanted to wash my eyes. Because repentance is something daily, something continuing every day. So three important things. Number one, the characteristic of a good repentance has to be firm, has to be complete. Number three has to be continuing every day to wash me thoroughly from my sin and wash me, O Lord. And the Lord required from Moses to look, in order for the people of Israel to see me, they must wash their clothes. And I like the expression clothes because we have to wash our clothes every day. Number four, which is the last point, has to be fruitful. Very important for repentance to be fruitful. I love the story of Zacchaeus. Give give us a good example of the fruit of repentance. After he met the Lord and told him, come down, make haste and come down, be today a Muslim in the house. He came and he confesses and told the Lord, half of my goods I give to the poor. And if I have taken anything from anyone by false accusation, I will restore fourfold. The fruit of repentance that he will go out and reconcile and give those who really made a law غلط فيهم يعني. فحبايبي النهارده بتكلم معاكم عن النهارده بنتكلم في القداس عن المولود اعمى وقلنا هو سيمبل النهارده المسج اخر شهر توبه عن التوبه عن المعموديه وقصه المولود اعمى ان هو السيد المسيح هو اللي راح له واول ما شاف مولود اعمى بدا هو اللي راح له فدايما ربنا يسعى لكل انسان مننا زي ما بيقول كده انا واقف على باب ايه اقرع ان فتح لي احد ادخل وايه واتعشى معه وبعد كده سؤال التلاميذ ليه قالوا له هذا اخطا ام ابواه فالسيد المسيح رد جميل جدا يعلمنا كيف الواحد لما تكون عنده مشكله ولا حاجه قال له لهذا اخطا ولا ابواه لايه لمجد الله وبالتالي لما تكون عندنا مشكله او هارد شيب او حد تعبان او مثلا اي نوع من المشكله نقول له هذه المشكله مش بس عشان واحد عمل غلط ولا حاجه ولكن ايه عشان ربنا يتمجد في حياتي ربنا يتغير في حياتي وبعد كده السيد المسيح قال له ايه حط على عينه اللي هو الكلي وقال له جو اند واش اغسل فذهب ويقول لك وغسل وبدا يرى اتكلمت معاكم مع الشباب على الموضوع ان هو التوبه الانسان اللي هو الاعمى ده مثال لكل انسان يقدم التوبه لان التوبه هي استناره روحيه التوبه ما الا هي استناره روحيه التوبه ما هي الا الواحد يتفتح عينه يشوف كل الامور مختلفه فهذا الشاب حبيبي اللي هو الاعمى ده كان مثال جميل للتوبه تكلمنا على اربع حاجات مهمين جدا في التوبه نمبر 1 انها تكون حامسه ولا تؤجل مشكلتنا كلنا في التوبه بكره 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 ودايما بكره ايه مش ممكن يجي ابدا وهو بولس الرسول قال كده في كورنثوس 2:6-2 بيقول ايه هو ذا الان وقت ايه مقبول هو ذا الان اللحظه دي هو ذا الان ايه يوم ايه يوم خلاص هذه اللحظه لحظه التوبه لحظه التوبه نمبر 2 اتكلمنا انها مهمه جدا ان التوبه تكون شاملة القلب شاملة الفكر شاملة الحواس شاملة الإرادة بل شاملة كل الأعمال ثالث شيء تكلمنا فيه حبيبة عن التوبة أنها تكون توبة مستمرة مهم جدا الواحد في حياته اليومية يمكن نشكر ربنا الإجبية بتعلم الواحد أنه هو إيه التوبة مش لحظة ولكن التوبة حياة والبابا شنودة ربنا ينح نفسه لما كتب كتاب عن التوبة كتب كتاب جميل قال لك إيه حياة التوبة لأن التوبة هي مش لحظة ولكن هي حياة كل يوم بحياها إن أنا أقدم توبة وخدنا مثال كده لما داود النبي أخطأ وقال اغسلني فأبيض أكثر من السرج وكم مرة الواحد بيغسل إيده ولا بيغسل أي شيء يتوسخ كده فالتوبة هي غسل كل يوم الواحد يقول له كده رب اغسلني فأبيض أكثر من السرج آخر حاجة تكلمنا فيها أحبائي إن هي التوبة تكون إيه مثمرة أهم حاجة إيه أعطوا ثمار لإيه للتوبة أعطوا ثمار للتوبة أختم لكم بقصة جميلة عن أبونا عن قوة التوبة وجمال التوبة أبونا قريتها لأبونا يوسف أسعد ربنا يحيي نفسه بيقول كده إن هو كان بيتردد على واحدة كانت بعيدة خالص من ربنا وعايش حياة خالص صعبة جدا يعني فهو كان بيتردد عليها ويكلمها ولا هي كان عندها إحساس خالص يعني فجي في يوم من الأيام هي اتصلت بيه بعد كذا مرة وأول ما اتصل بيه بيقول لما وصلت عندها البيت قالت له عايز اقول لك على حاجه انا قررت ان انا اقدم توبه قويه ولا عوده ولا رجوع تعمل التوبه فبيقول بعد كده اتكلمت تسال السؤال وهو قاعد معاه تقول له انا على فكره العماره الحلوه دي اللي انت شايفها الكبيره دي كل فلوسها جايه من الحرام اعمل ايه في الفلوس دي فهو بيقول كده كنت بتكلم معاه قال له على فكره خد الفلوس دي وارميها كده ايه في البحر فبيقول بعد كده لبست ونزلت معاه في الاوضه بتاعته في العربيه بتاعته وهو ماشي في الطريق كده قلت له ممكن تقف دقيقتين فوقف كده فنزلت جرت وكان معها شنطه كبيره كانت هي مليانه كل الفلوس كاش فراحت فضتها قدامه كده قدام عينيه في البحر وسابت الفلوس كلها فاول ما رجع بيقول يا سلام على جمال التوبه وبعد كده هو بيحكي القصه دي بيقول انا بحكي لكم القصه دي لاني اليوم ده انا كنت حاضر جنازتها والعجيب جدا اول ما وصلت احضر الجنازه بتاعتها فبيقول مسكت ايديها قبلت ايديها لاني لما دخلت عشان اسلم عليها لقيت ريحه بخور طالعه من جسمها وريحه عطره جميله جدا راح من جسمها يا جمال التوبه ويا حلاوه التوبه لما الانسان فعلا يقرر يقول له ايه اليوم يوم خلاص والوقت وقت مقبول، إن سمعتم صوته فإيه فلا تخسوا قلوبكم. ربنا فعلا يدينا التوبة اليومية، يدينا التوبة أنه يقول له يا رب تعالى يا من أفتحت عيني الأعمى النهاردة، فتح يا رب عين قلبي، فتح عين يا رب حياتي، فتح عين يا رب حواسي، فتح يا رب عين نفسي، ادينا رب عين يا رب مختلفة خالص حتى أراك أنت الإله الحقيقي، ولنا كل مجد والكرامة إلى الأبد.